Hello student, so in the previous class we have discussed about advantage and disadvantage of network. So today I will start from here, your page number 5, network hardware. So what is a network hardware? That means we all know that hardware means some devices. So in a network we need some devices like cable, hub, router, modem. So this kind of device we call network. Okay, so whenever we will connect a computer to a network, we need this kind of devices, mainly modem or router or cable or hub or network interface card. So this which picture you can see here, that figure number, this 1.3, 1.4, 1.5 and 1.6. So here these are the picture of this network hardware devices. Okay, so this, using this device we can connect our computer to a network. Okay, so about network we have already discussed. So let us come to structure of network. So you can see here I have written the structure of network. So there are some structure of network that mean to build a network of computer, we need to set up some structure. Okay, so there are three kind of main network structure. Number one, bus topology. Number two, star topology. Number three, ring topology. So you can see, if you go through your book, you can see at page number 6, bus topology. So bus topology mean what? In bus topology network, there you can see so many computers, like 100 or 200 or more than 100. Okay, these computers, how they are connected? They connected to a single cable. There will be a single cable, and in this cable all these computers will be connected. Okay, so this one very easy also. So I have written here, there will be a single cable, we call it as a bus. Okay, so it is, the bus topology is very easy to set up. Whenever we set up this bus topology network in a building or in a school or in a project or in any offices, this installation is very easy. Okay, so easy to install this one. Again, other disadvantage is that whenever this cable will be if cable does not work, that time what it happen, the whole network will be erased or the network will not work. That means if I have connected one cable in 10 room, if the main cable will not work, that time the whole setup will be erased. Okay, so this is the main disadvantage of this bus topology. Now let us come in star topology. You can see the page number 5, star topology. So in star topology there is a main hub. That means one device, what we call hub. So in this hub, all these connection, that means cable of these computers will be connected. Okay, that means the hub will act as a main server. Okay, so whatever cables are there, the all cables will directly connect to this hub, and the all computer will work through this hub only. So if sharing any data, or whenever we share or we need any data, this hub will have. Okay, this is the main device in this star topology network. Again, now see, here is one problem is that you can see here, if the hub will fail, that means if the main hub or the main device, what I already told, that like a server, if that will fail, that means if this one does not work, that time what will happen, the whole network will go down. That means the network cannot run properly. This one the main disadvantage of this star topology network. Okay, so let us come to number 3, ring topology network. That means what? In a ring topology network, there what it happen, the computers will be connected to a cable to each other. if in this room there is a computer and others computers are in different room, and whole the computers will be interconnected to a cable in a like a ring, that means in a like a, just a model like a ring, the all computers will be connected. Okay, so in this network it is very easy to work, set up and easy to work also there. And this main disadvantage of this network is that disadvantage, okay, if the cable will, if a single computer, that means whatever computers are connected there, if a single computer will not work, then the whole entire ring, the system will not work. That means it will be very big problem if one computer will doesn't work. Okay, so these are, there are some disadvantage also and advantage also. Okay, so visual this structure of network. Now let's come to type of network. So I already told in some classes that in where we use this network, computer network system. So that means like our mobile network system, this one also same. Or you can we can give one example like cable TV network. This one also one example of a network. Okay, you can see here type of network. First one is what? Local area network, LAN or LAN. That means in a one building, if the all computers will be connected, okay, connected through a network, that will be LAN. That means it will be very small in size and we can use it in school or any office. Okay, that means local area network, it will be very small in size. Again, number B, metropolitan area network, that means MAN or MAN. So that means this metropolitan, that means in a large office or in a like in a universities, that means there should be a very big place where there are lots of computers and all computers will be connected through in this MAN network. Okay, so third is what? Wide area network, that means WAN. It means if there is a there is one company and that company has so many building or offices in a state. Okay, each district there they have office, and what will be there, the whole offices will be connected through cable or satellite, mainly by cable. Like how this cable TV network will work, the same way the whole offices will connect and that will interconnected. Okay, so this process is work mainly work in a big offices. In big offices this kind of network we can see, and this LAN we can see in very small small area in a school or in a fixed building we can see also, and MAN we can see in a large office. Okay, so these were this structure of network and type of network. So you also go through your book. Okay, so whatever exercise part are now part are now remain, I will send you by WhatsApp, and till then take care. So thank you.